Good morning, student. Welcome back to our math session. In last session, we see the exercise 3.2 mid, median, mode, and median. Okay. Today we see the next part of this chapter, that is use of bar graph with different purpose. Okay. So here you already know that how to represent the data. We use the tally marks, then a pictograph. In pictograph we use the picture, then pie chart and bar graph. So here representing the data using pictograph is a time consuming, and at the time it become difficult to represent the data using pictograph when data given is too large and not to multiply. For this purpose we use bar graph, and bar graph can represent data conveniently and effectively. What is the definition of bar graph? Bar graph is a graphical representation of numerical data in the form of rectangular bars of equal width. Or how to write the definition here? It is the chart with vertical or horizontal bar to represent the data. Okay, so here this is about bar graph. And what is the properties of bar graph? Bar graph. So first we see advantage of bar graph. Bar graph are easy to draw, read and understand. And comparison is easier with bar graph. Okay, see here. We write here, draw bar graph here. First step you have to construct the bar graph is first draw horizontal line. And this horizontal line is called x axis. Okay, this is x axis. And vertical line is called y-axis. So here you have to always indicate here x and y. Okay. Then on graph paper, you have to use the graph paper or your last year graph notebook. Okay. On horizontal line, draw bars at an equal distance and write the name of the items for which the data to be represented. Here we write, suppose we write here data. Favorite colors. Okay, the favorite colors of a student. Okay, and in your class. So here we write the favorite color, and here we write the number of student. This is your second step. So here we write the suppose student. Then choose the suitable scale which will determine the height of each bar. So here, suppose your data is given. So you have to use suitable scale. So this is very important, scale. So suppose your data is given. Suppose you are in your class. 60 student like pink color. Then 40 student like blue color, then 30 student like purple color, and 10 student like yellow color. Okay, this is given, suppose, and you have to draw the bar graph. How to draw? So you have to take a scale, suitable scale. This is very important. Okay, this is 1 mark. So you have to write the scale. तो यहाँ पे आपको क्या करना है, see the numbers. Numbers given 10, 30, 40, 60. So you have to take a suitable scale. Means you have to start from here 0. So you have to write here 0 first. At this intersecting point, okay? 0, then you have to take suitable scale. 10, 20, then 30, 40, 50, 60 and 70. Okay, now you have to write here the colors. Which colors are given? Pink color, then blue color, purple color and yellow color. Okay, these colors are given. Now by using scale you have to draw the color bars. Then find out the different height as per the scale, and spacing between the bar should be equal. So here we left equal space between two bars. Okay, so here you have to first mark pink color. Here is 60 is pink color. Then you have to draw the bar graph. Here we draw the graphs. Okay, pink 60, blue 40 student like blue, 30 student like purple and yellow color. Okay, this is यहाँ पे हमने क्या पे बोर्ड पे राइट ड्रॉ किया. यू हैव टू ड्रॉ दिस बार ग्राफ इन यूर ऑन ग्राफ पेपर. ओके, यू हैव टू यूज ग्राफ पेपर टू ड्रॉ दी बार ग्राफ. सो हियर पिंक कलर, यू हैव टू यूज कलर हियर और ड्रॉ अ स्लांटिंग लाइन इन दिस बार ग्राफ. ओके, इन दिस वे वी ड्रॉ दी बार ग्राफ. नाउ वी सी वन एग्जाम्पल हियर. We solve the question number 1. Use the bar graph figure 3.3 and answer the following question. Which is the most popular pet? Okay, so here this is bar graph is given and scale is given here. So which is popular pet here? Which bar graph is greater in height? See height of the bar graph. This is bigger. So which is favorite pet? So you have to write here cats. Cats, how many student like cats? 10 student like cats. So your answer is cats. Then how many student have dog as a pet? So dog. So how many student like dog? See the bar graph. This is 8 bar graphs up to 8. So 8 student like dogs as a pet animal. So this is your second first question. Then second question you have to write yourself. Okay, then we see third question. A number of children in a 6 different classes are given below. Now represent the data on the bar graph. Okay, so here you see class 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then number of children given 135, 120 in 6th standard. 795, 800, 990, and 1080. Now first you have to take your bar graph. Okay, bar graph book. If you have a last year bar graph book, आपके book में pages हो गए तो आप वो last year की भी use कर सकते हो. Okay, so take your bar graph book. See here, this is your bar graph book. First you have to write draw the x axis and y axis, means horizontal line and vertical line. First we draw the horizontal line and vertical line. There this is x axis, to write here x and here y. Okay, and now you have to select the scale. Scale is very important. Okay, the data, number of children given 135 in 5th standard, 120 in 6th standard, 7th standard 95, then 8th standard 100 children and 9th standard 90 and 10th standard 80. Now you have to choose. How to choose? See here, आपको कैसे करना है? Number देखना है. You have to see the number 135, 120, 95, 100, 90, 80. So if you take a 10, 20, 30. Suppose we first start from 10. 20, आपको ऐसा नंबर लेने हैं, ऐसे स्केल चूज करनी है जिसमें सब नंबर आ सकते हैं. ओके, तो वी टेक द नंबर, दिस इज ज़ीरो, दिस इज ज़ीरो. ओके, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 एंड दिस इज 100, 110, 120, 130, 140 and 150. Greater number is in your book 135. Okay, so here we take up to number 150. And this is, what is this? This is number of children. To write this, number of children. Okay, this is your step first. To write here, scale is very important. This scale for 1 marks, again this is 1 marks scale. So we write here this distance means 1 centimeter. 1 2 line ka distance kitna likhna hai aapko, right? Or unit likhna hai. 1 unit is equal to वन यूनिट इज इक्वल टू 10. 10 क्या लिया है हमने? चिल्ड्रंस लिया है, नंबर ऑफ चिल्ड्रन. तो 10 चिल्ड्रन, वन यूनिट इज इक्वल टू 10 चिल्ड्रन. तो दिस इज योर स्केल. ओके, वन यूनिट, दिस इज वन यूनिट, दिस इज वन वन बॉक्स मीन्स वन यूनिट. वन यूनिट इज इक्वल टू 10 चिल्ड्रन. नाउ यू हैव टू राइट हियर, व्हाट इज राइट हियर? क्लासेस. क्लास कौन सा क्लास आएगा? सो फर्स्ट यू हैव टू लेफ्ट दिस फर्स्ट कॉलम, ये कॉलम आपको छोड़ देना है. देन सेकेंड कॉलम यू हैव टू राइट फिफ्थ क्लास. तो एफ आई एफ टी ए, दिस इज फिफ्थ क्लास. ओके, एंड फिफ्थ क्लास. देन अगेन वन बॉक्स लेफ्ट करना है, दे वन कॉलम लेफ्ट करके सिक्स्थ, अगेन लेफ्ट वन कॉलम सेवेंथ, अगेन लेफ्ट वन कॉलम एट, देन अगेन लेफ्ट वन कॉलम नाइन. तो यू हैव टू राइट दिस टाइप ऑल्सो, नाइन्थ, देन दे टेंथ. यू हैव टू राइट हियर क्लासेस फिफ्थ सिक्स सेवेंथ एट नाइन टेन. ओके, नाउ फिफ्थ क्लास हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट, नंबर ऑफ चिल्ड्रंस इन फिफ्थ क्लास 135. सो हियर वेयर इज 135? हियर वी गेट 130. एंड 135 कहाँ पे आएगा? बिटवीन द 130 एंड 140. तो मिडल लाइन दिस, दिस इज 5 की लाइन है. ओके, दिस इज मिडल लाइन. तो हियर यू हैव टू मेक अ मार्क एंड बाय यूजिंग स्केल यू हैव टू जॉइन दिस लाइन. ओके, दिस इज 135. देन नेक्स्ट इज सिक्स. In sixth class, how many student? 120. Where is 120? See here. Again, here you have to make a mark and join the line. Here we get 120 for sixth standard. Then 795. Again, where is 90? 95 कहाँ पे आएगा? Between 90 and 100. So you have to make a mark here and join this line. By using scale, here you have to use this scale. Okay, then next 8. How many student in 8? 100. Where is 100? See here. Here is 100. So you have to make a mark here and join the line by using scale. This is 100. Then next 9th. 90 student. 90 children. So here you have to make a mark and join the line. So here we get the graph here. And last 10th 80. So you have to make again mark 80 on 80 and join the lines. Okay, this is your bar graph. Okay, so in this way you have to draw bar graph. Now your question is given, how would you choose a scale? How to use? By on which basis? We see the number of children in each class. Okay, so here we take one unit is equal to 10 children. Okay, then next answer the following question. First is given. So first question is given, which class has the maximum number of children and minimum? Maximum which class? Fifth standard. Okay, fifth class. How many students? 135. And minimum in 10th standard, only 80 children. Okay, then we find the ratio of student of class 6 to student of class 8. Find the ratio of student here. How to find in 6th class? How many student here? Ratio of student class 6. Class 6, how many student here? 120. And ratio is to the student of 8th class. How many student in 8th class? 100. Okay. So 120 divided by 100. We write the ratio in this way also. So we got the number 2, 5 is 10, 2, 6 is 12. So we get the ratio 6 to 5. This is ratio of the student of class 5, 6 and class 8, okay? So you have to solve this question in your graph book, okay? Thank you.